Good morning, everybody. Welcome to this full authority meeting of the Niagara Peninsula Conservation Authority this Friday, October the 21st. First of all, I'd like to do the call to order, and I'm going to turn it over to Grant to do our roll call.
Good morning, everyone. Do we have Mr. Beattie?
Present.
Member Brady?
I am here.
I have regrets from Member Clark. Member Cridland? Member Fior?
Good morning.
Member Halinga?
Present.
Member Hewson?
Present.
Member Ingrail?
Present.
Member Johnson?
Good morning.
Good morning. I have regrets from Member Kaywall. Member McKenzie? Member Metcalf? I see him here. Member Rapley?
Member Metcalf here.
I have regrets from Member Sherton. Member Smith?
Yes.
And I have regrets from Member Steele. Member Woodhouse? For members in attendance, I think there is an on button on the side of your mic. You may need to switch it on the right side. And Member Wright?
Present.
And of course, Chair Foster.
And yes, I am present. Thank you, Grant. And just for those, we just had a minor technical glitch here, but I think we've got it sorted out. And Member Cridland did say she may have to leave at some point, dealing with some family issues. The Niagara Peninsula watershed is situated within the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee, Attawandaronk, and the Anishinaabeg, including the Mississaugas of the Credit, many of whom continue to live and work here today. This territory is covered by the Upper Canada Treaties and is within the land protected by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Agreement. Today, the watershed is home to many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples. Through the 2021 to 2023 strategic plan, we reconfirm our commitment to shared stewardship of natural resources and deep appreciation of Indigenous culture and history in the watershed. First of all, we would like to do approval of the agenda. Is there anything anyone wishes to add to the agenda or change within the order? I'm seeing none. Member Hewson, would you move that we accept the agenda? And Member Fior, would you second that, please? Mr. Smith, please go ahead.
Yeah, I'm just not sure if it's correct, but I did note that we were going to change the agenda. Weren't we going to remove a few items to have the special meeting on November 4th? Should that happen at this point?
We're going to actually deal with that when we get to that point within the agenda. So that would be under discussion items, and that's when that would come up in place of the actual policies at that point.
Okay.
Great. Okay, anyone opposed to us with the agenda at this point? Thank you. Any declarations of conflict of interest? Seeing none, approval of minutes. So can I get Mr. Beattie to move that we do the approval of the minutes of the full authority meeting dated September 16th, 2022, and the minutes of the full authority closed session minutes dated September 16th, 2022? Mr. Beattie, would you move that? Member Wright, would you second that, please?
I wasn't actually at the meeting in September, so maybe someone else should.
It doesn't really matter with that, but I'll have Mr. Smith do the seconding of that. Is there anyone opposed to us accepting these minutes? That's carried. Chair's update. So, Lots of stuff been going on with the NPCA the last little while, to say the least. Couple of things that I wanted to note, and I know it may overlap a little bit with Chandra's report later on. Chandra and I had an opportunity, we were invited by our former CAO, Gail Wood, to attend the International Joint Commission meeting that was going on in Niagara on the Lake. We came and did a discussion on a variety of things in and around the NPCA. Chandra will be able to detail a little bit further what we actually were able to accomplish with that meeting, but suffice it to say it was a very positive situation for us with the NPCA and being invited to that. Chandra and I, along with Director Christie, we were at a meeting down at the St. Catharines Museum as well, with a big funding announcement that was going on. The federal government is moving out a lot of tourism money at this particular point in time. The two main features of that meeting was money's going to the St. Catharines Museum for accessibility work that's going on at that particular facility. The second was for money's going to the Lincoln Park in the Jordan Hollow, which is going to have a strong Indigenous focus when it's all said and done. So major funding announcements there. Of course, with us, with the NPCA, we have been able to receive approximately $750,000 from the federal government for the various projects that we have going, which is hugely positive as well. Outside of that, just to let you know, the composition of the new board that's going to be coming up went to the Hamilton Council, and the request from Niagara Region was rejected. So I suspect what's going to end up happening is there's going to be some sort of an order coming into place to show exactly what the new structure is going to be. Anyway, that's going on between the CAOs of the city of Hamilton, the county of Haldimand, and of course the CAO of Niagara Region. That's about it for me. The Balls Falls Festival has completed. Mr. Christie and CEO Charma will be having a further discussion on that later on in this meeting. Correspondence. We do have some correspondence items this morning. So first of all, the main one here is the correspondence dated September the 13th, 2022, from Carol Schofield, Manager of the Legislative Services, the Clerk of the Town of Fort Erie. Mr. Bivol, since we requested a motion on this, any comments on this particular issue?
I have no comment other than that in your agenda as well, there was drafted a motion or a proposed motion to extend that deadline.
Thank you. So we'll do this in two parts. Number one, we will receive the correspondence, and then there's a secondary motion that's coming into play to extend the NPCA final land securement strategy and deadline moved to January the 31st. So first, to accept this, Mr. Halinga, would you please move that we accept the correspondence Mr. Wright, would
I
you
will.
Second? Yep. And Mr. Wright, would you second that, please? Thank you. Is there anyone opposed to us accepting this correspondence? Thank you. And now a motion to extend the NPCA final land securement strategy deadline to January the 31st, 2023. And sorry, Mr. Bivol, I don't have the exact motion in front of me at the moment. Okay, here we are. So, Member Fior, would you please move that staff be directed to extend the deadline for comment on the final land strategy, securement strategy, to January 31st, 2023, in order to provide sufficient time for your stakeholders to undertake a review and provide comments? Yep, thank you. And can I get Member Brady to second that, please?
I have a question first. Okay. I may not be supporting this motion, so perhaps okay. I shouldn't second it.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, so Member Johnson, would you second this motion, please? Thank you. So go ahead, Mr. Brady, you're first, and then Member Fiore after that.
So what this would effectively do is place this item on the next Conservation Authority Board and on the next, I guess, politicians from Fort Erie. I'm not sure why there was, I read the correspondence. There was nothing in the correspondence that suggested why exactly they needed this extra time. So I'd like to hear from staff as to whether or not this will affect our moving forward with dealing with land acquisition strategy.
We'll turn it over to Director Leilani.
Thank you, through the chair. The extension for the commenting deadline, we received more informal from some other municipalities as well. It wasn't just Fort Erie. So in consideration of the overall request to extend that commenting deadline, we are moving forward to allowing to the end of January, but we still want to pursue approval depending on the comments that are received and any revisions that would need to be made to hopefully bring it forward by the end of this board's term, if we can. I believe, I'm not exactly sure on the timing to bring the final forward, but it may have to be in the new board, but we will do what we can to see if we can bring it forward by the end of this board's term.
Thank you, Mr. Brady.
I'm fine.
Thank you. Member Fiore.
For that, through you, Chair. My question was as well with respect to the timeline, how this might affect our timeline to move the strategy forward. Leilani just mentioned that there were other municipalities that made this request. Fort Erie made it more formally. For the sake of transparency, can you maybe share the other municipalities and then confirm that this won't have a negative impact on us moving forward with the strategy? Thank you.
Through you, Mr. Chair, unfortunately, I don't have the exact municipalities. I can follow up, and I'll commit to do our best to bring it forward by the end of the term of this board. We've had some feedback already on the strategy, and there is interest with the municipalities, particularly from the planning side, and looking at how we can work with them through the planning process to provide guidance and policies for gratuitous dedication through the planning approval process. So that's very positive in terms of those discussions that we've had to date. So we haven't received any negative feedback, if that's helpful. It has seemed to be positive to date in the discussions we've had. So we will continue to keep the lines of communication open going forward, and hopefully we can bring this forward for completion during the term of the board.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Chair.
Anyone else? Member Cridlin.
Thank you, through you, Chair. So what I think I'm hearing is that staff can recommend and support this extension and not delay the overall goals. Is there room for this to be amended then to a December timeline for the municipalities to achieve or to be more safe with our deadlines? So again, just deferring to staff to make sure that we've got what you need to be able to deliver. Thank you.
Through the chair, I think the question is, can we respond back to Fort Erie to request for comments by end of December? Was that the request? We could have that discussion, make that request. When we met with staff, their position was they did need the time and they did want to put this forward to the new council for their comments. So that was their direction and why they were requesting that comment.
Member Crillon.
Thank you for that clarification. I also tend to not want the next round to be involved. However, this is the process that would make it better. That's fine. So I'm not sure that I can support it yet. Thank you.
Just a second, Member Rapley. Okay. First of all, Member Smith is next online, and then yourself, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, I'd just like to quickly express my concern, too, that we, this board, has an opportunity to deal with this issue, and I understand the municipality's asking for extensions, but I don't think it's unreasonable for us to say we can extend till such and such a date, and then at that point we have to go forward, just to make sure that this board is the one that actually closes this issue, if that's the right way to put it. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Just one moment, please. Thank you, Member Smith. The our board has the ability, if we wish, to adjust the dates on this, if we so desire. In discussions going on with Director Yates as well as the CAO, they would be amenable to having a date change to November of this year. To be brought forward to the December board meeting. So if somebody wishes to move such a change, it certainly would be a good thing. Oh, I see everybody wants to do that. So we'll start with Member Smith as being the one that we changed the date to the November, which date, November 30th, or what would be the date, Member Director Yates?
Through the chair, if I can request by November 18th to give us time to prepare our report to the board.
Okay, great, thank you. So November 18th, so that'll be changed to that. Member Smith and Member Brady, would you second that, please? Okay, so all in favor of this amendment to the motion? And that is carried. Which brings us to the motion itself, which has been moved and seconded. Member Rapley, do you wish to speak to this as well?
Yes, I just want to make the point that there are a lot of potential eyes and ears out there, including, say, the three nature clubs, the bird groups, et cetera, and land may become available at any time. We need to make sure we have, you know, we have a 10-year plan, but we also have to have flexibility such that, for instance, if Parks Canada decides that the shoreline property in Niagara, which has been under discussion, that they want a partnership with NPCA in the town, that we can bring things forward as they come along, pieces of land become available. We need to make sure we have flexibility. And I know a 10-year plan is important for the planning part of it, but we must also be able to seize and acquire things as they become available.
Thank you, Member Rapley. Anyone else have any comments? Seeing none, that actually worked really well, saying all in favor. So all in favor of this motion. And that is carried. Let us move on to our presentations this morning. We have a PowerPoint presentation by Kara Wienecki, Director of Practice Planning Solutions, Inc., David DeLuce, our Senior Manager, Environmental Planning and Policy, and Leanne Lee Yates, our Director, Watershed Management, concerning the draft NPCA policy document review. Oh, okay, here, just a second. Is there anything that you guys would like to talk about with this at this point, or we simply are doing our delay to all of this? I'm going over to Director Yates.
Thank you, through the chair. Our staff have been working very hard and are very dedicated to this project. At this point, with the draft document, we want to take the time to make sure it's fulsome, complete, and that the board has the opportunity to take the time to review it. So we didn't want to rush it at this time. So that's the request for having the special meeting and delaying this particular presentation and the information that will come forward. But we will make this presentation should the board wish to have that special meeting. And we will be before you with all the details and information that we intended to present today.
Okay, thank you, Director Yates. And my request to you is that when the policies and stuff are going out, can you also circulate the presentation at that point to all committee members so that everybody can have a chance to go through it? This is relatively important for us as we go through this as well. So, okay, thank you. We don't have any delegations this morning. We do have a couple of consent items. Report number FA4222, Recompliance and Enforcement, and also report number FA4322, 2022 NPCA Quarterly Progress Report number 2, required for the Conservation Authority Act's amendments, transition plan and agreements. Both of these are for receipt. Can I get Member Fiore to move that we accept these reports? And can I get Member Rapley to second that, please? Any questions to either one of these reports? Seeing none, all those who are in favor of accepting this? And that is carried. Oh, I have a hand that came up late there. Sorry. I'm not sure who that is.
Just my agreement.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Jack. Discussion items. So this morning, our discussion items, report number FA3222, NPCA rebranding rollout. Chandra, do you wish to speak to this particular report, or who would you like to speak to it? Rebecca? Rebecca, would you like to speak to this report this morning?
Good morning. Through you, Chair, the report in front of you is related to the rebranding. We've consulted extensively with staff and took their feedback, and what you have before you is the change in the logo and the branding, which will be used on materials such as website, promotional materials, business cards, business plans, etc. And I'm sure if you read the report, you'll also realize that we have the leaf divided into three sections now. It still represents a tulip leaf, but the three sections represent our municipalities and our escarpment and water and land. To just indicate the purpose, we also have it slightly shifted a little, so it's turned a little to also show forward movement and to make it look more active. So that's just a brief overview. In terms of the rollout planning, we have it done in a couple of phases. The first phase will be updating the website and most of the business collateral, which we hope to have done by end of 2022. And then in 2023 and beyond, we'll work on other materials as we go forward.
Thank you, Rebecca. Can I get Member Ingrao to move that we accept this report? Or approve this report, and Member Beattie, would you second it, please? Great, thank you. No, that's okay. We're putting the report on the floor. So, So, Member Hewson, please go ahead.
Thank you, Chair. Very exciting to see a refresh on our logo and how our brand's going to be refreshed. You did mention, Rebecca, that we're going to be updating the website. I'm wondering, the new colors do not align. If we're going to be pretty stick with the colors that you've identified as our in our new branding, they don't align with the website. I'm wondering, is this going to require some external investment to help us maybe refresh the website, or are we intending to do that exclusively internally?
Through you, Chair. Basically, the colors, they're in a gradient, so there will be a guideline document that will be created and done shortly. So for the website colors, they'll be in a deeper of those shades. Diane, to help answer that question. In regards to the refresh on the website, it'll be done internally. We have our designer who'll be working on that. He's also the one who worked with us to actually create the logo itself. So everything's been done internally up to this point. We're also planning on doing an audit or a refresh on the actual website itself and making sure that it ties in not only with rebranding, but with the needs of the public who actually visit the site itself.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so just to confirm, we're planning to do all of that internally, because I know that if we, you know, if we're looking externally, I'm not sure if we've talked about a budget for that, so.
Internally, yes.
Great, okay. Okay, it looks great. Great, great. Good job, thank you.
Member Hlinga.
Thank you. And just a question on accessibility. Those that may be visually impaired, do these fonts and the clarity all align with the regulations?
Through you, Chair, yes. We are taking that into consideration. We're making sure we're AODA compliant. We're also working with Human Resources, who actually manages that, to make sure that the website and all of our materials are accessible. We also have a high contrast, that's the black and white, which I believe is included in the document, which will also be used to help with accessibility.
Member Hlinga?
Thank you, and that's exactly the answer I was looking for.
Thank you. I see no other questions coming into play. Sorry. Member Woodhouse, sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I was hoping that being here in person would have some advantage here, but apparently it doesn't. yeah, that's right, yeah. Yeah, who am I? The question I have is in relationship to inventory of stock that we have. Is the plan to proceed to run that out, or is it going to be a total replacement as after we pass this?
Rebecca?
I needed to hit talk. it's a phased approach, so that's the reasoning for making sure that we are taking into account the materials we have. The timing is actually really great. We have run out of a number of different promotional materials, so it actually was partly considered that we were making sure things like how we promote our conservation areas, for example, those brochures and flyers are actually almost out of print. So it's a good time for us to actually do some rebranding and some changes. So I think it's the timing is actually aligned very nicely. We also have a number of new staff. So the business cards we've held off until today's presentation in order to ensure that new staff will also be getting the new cards. And then we'll slowly phase in the rebrand with the other staff, previous staff as well. Just for an example.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for that answer. I suspect that was the case. I just wanted it on the record so that anybody watching this shows that we're being fiscally responsible. Thank you.
Thank you, Member Woodhouse. Any other questions? Seeing none, all those that are in favor of us accepting this. And that is carried. Second discussion item this morning, report number FA 4122, concerning Niagara Peninsula Conservation Authority appointment of regulation officers. Member Halinga, can I get you to move that we approve this report? And Member Johnson, would you second it, please?
I will.
Yeah. Thank you. Reports on the floor. Any questions to this report? Seeing none, all those who are in favor? And that is carried. We're getting to item 9C, which is the draft NPCA policies. So, of course, this is being delayed. What we would like to do this morning is actually have a motion to do a special meeting on November the 4th. Mr. Bivol, do you want us to do that now, or would you prefer we do that later in the agenda?
It can be at your leisure, sir.
No, leisure. Okay. At my discretion is what you're saying. Okay.
True.
Okay. So Grant has circulated a motion for the special meeting for November the 4th. Member Hewson, can I get you to move that we accept that? And Member Fiore, would you please second that? Any questions to this motion? Please go ahead, Member Fiore.
Thank you. And through you to the chair, I've seen something yesterday about how the provincial government has plans to make some significant changes to municipal zoning rules. And I haven't seen anything official from the province, just seems a little bit of a rumor mill, but I wanted to confirm to ask staff if they've received any information about changes that are proposed post-municipal election. So word on Twitter, that's where I got the information, through newspaper articles that the day after the election, there will be some municipal zoning rules coming out that might affect conservation authorities. So if we could receive any information from staff, if they've been notified by the province, and if they have, how this might be integrated into these policies. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Member Fiore. And suffice it to say, the province is abuzz right at the moment with these changes that are coming through. And there was a significant article in the Toronto Star this morning talking about the changes that are potentially coming. But of course, it's all backwater, back channel, rumor mill information at this point. But it does seem that there are changes that are coming into play. Our CAO and I had a brief discussion late last night about this, and you know, the reality is that there are probably other changes that are going to be coming into play in and around policy that we're going to have to deal with, provided the province actually passes and moves a lot of this information through. So I guess the answer to you, Member Fiore, is that we shall see. It's the province has provided no information down and then through to the CAAs nor to municipalities at this point. So this could be a blessing in disguise for us moving our policies off a little bit because there may be other changes that are going to have to come into play at some point as well. So I hope that answers your question.
Thank you. So then you're confirming that staff do not have any information from the province on this matter?
That's correct.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, everybody's sort of it's in the newspaper, but that's about it mode with all of this. So any other questions to this? Oh, and by the way, Mr. Bivol also said that it'll be a fully electronic meeting on November the 4th, so there'll be no in-person that goes along with that. So all those in favor? And that is carried. Committee reports. So we shall move to the Governance Committee report. The minutes from the meeting of the Governance Committee dated September the 15th, 2022. This is for receipt. Member Engrao, can you please move that we accept that? And Member Metcalf, would you please second that?
I second it.
Yes, thank you. All those in favor of receiving those minutes? That is carried. We also have the minutes of the Governance Committee dated October the 14th, 2022, again for receipt. Can I get Member Ingrao to move that we accept those minutes? Can I get Member Smith to be the seconder for that? Thank you. All those in favor, please. And that is carried. In just 1 second. Great. So one of the things that was that came out of that governance committee meeting was a copy of the presentation entitled Phase 2 Discussion Papers, Engagement Summary Report and Direction for Policies and Procedural Manual. And the Governance Committee asked that that be specifically received by the board itself. So Member Ingrao, can I get you to move that we receive the presentation entitled Phase 2 Discussion Papers, ... And Member Smith, would you please second that? Thank you. Any questions to this? Go ahead, Member Hewson.
I think I might have gotten ahead of myself. I was looking for page 51, slide 13. I think that's report GC 11-22 in my head. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. We're just we're just trying to catch up to where you are. So,
no, sorry, it's actually on. It's page 54 of the agenda. I think it's on. I think it's the next item. I'll put my hand down.
Okay. Okay. So you have no question with this at this point, then? Okay. All those in favor of us accepting that presentation. That is carried. And the other item that came out of that was report number GC 1122, NPCA Policy Document Review and Procedural Manual Phase 2 Project, the Engagement Summary Report and Policy and Procedural Manual Direction. My mouth is not working. Member Ingrao, would you please move that we receive this report? Member Johnson, would you please second that? Member Hewson, I believe you have a question to this.
Yes, thank you. It's page 51, which is slide 13, areas of a divergent ecological net gain. I just wanted clarification. There was a comment here. The fourth bullet was inclusion of policies that deviate from those recently adopted by the Niagara region within their new official plan presents a problematic scenario. Could somebody please articulate what that refers to?
I'm going to pass this to Director Yates.
Thank you for the through the chair. This relates to Niagara Region's policy in their wetland section that states generally it states while the NPCA may have policies related to offsetting for wetlands, the region does not support offsetting as mitigation. I think that's the language. So that's a specific policy that's in there, and that's a comment that was raised through the consultation about how we will bring our policies or align with that direction in the official plan.
Okay, thank you for that. So I'm interpreting that as the region has more restrictive policies with regards to wetlands than we do, and we need to bring our policy into conformity with those rules. Is that correct?
In response, and our understanding from regional staff is their policies do not support forms of offsetting or compensation.
Okay.
So that's the input that we received from them.
Okay, thank you for that.
Thank you, Member Hewson. Anyone else? Seeing none, all those in favor of us receiving this report. Thank you. Also, we have the Public Advisory Committee minutes from the meeting of the Public Advisory Committee dated September 29th, 2022. Member Wright, can I get you to move that we receive those minutes? And Member Ingrao, would you please second that? Thank you. Any questions to this? Member Fior.
Thank you, through you, Chair. Is the discussion paper made available on our website outside of this agenda?
Yes, so it's actually posted as part of the PAC information on the website.
Okay, thank you. And I'm wondering, under our learning tab on the website, would it be possible to have reports and resources made available there? I ask because in research, I make use of discussion papers and I go to different websites and I look to their learning or their resource tabs. And I just think that this has some important information that could be maybe easier to find if it was under such a tab as learning. So I'm not proposing direction here. I'm just maybe asking the question, would it be possible in this this time that we're actually making some adjustments to the website, how it looks visually, would it be possible to update that learning tab to include some of these really well-written reports that the NPCA and the PAC have been putting out to ensure that people that are looking for this information can find it a little bit easier?
If I understand correctly, you're asking to have basically a specialty web area to display some of these reports that we consider important and available in a much easier format, correct?
Yes, that's what I'm suggesting, and I'm wondering how it might fit under something like the learning tab. Thank you.
I'll turn this over to Rebecca, I think. Is this something that you're going to take under advisement and come back to us as a potential?
Through you, Chair, yes, we can certainly do that. We're also trying to improve our governance page, so that's where I'm trying to add some further information, so we can certainly add a resource section there as well.
Thank you, Member. Member Fior, anything else?
Thank you. I think I just wanted to reinforce the importance of making these documents easily available to the public.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Seeing no other questions, all those in favor of receiving these minutes? That is carried. I noticed you this time, Mel. So, and the second part to this is the report that Member Fior was talking about, which is the response to Public Advisory Committee discussion paper within this, and we are going to receive that separately. So, Member Fior, can I get you to move that? Member Wright, would you please second that? Thank you. Any questions to this? All those in favor? And that is carried. Do we have any, we don't have any motions. Do we have any notices of motion this morning from any members? Seeing none, we'll go down to new business. We will move to the CAO updates. No. I'm having an argument with the CAO at this point. Actually, she wishes to change the order, so let us go to Member Cridlin and the discussion about the foundation. Member Cridlin?
Thank you both through you. There is a nice little update from the foundation. We've got four things to talk about. The NPCF hosted a welcome table at the 48th Annual Balls Falls Festival over Thanksgiving. We had NPCA staff member Rebecca Hull keeping us organized, and board members Diana Hewson, Tom Insignia, and myself talking to visitors and selling lots of raffled tickets to win a chance at a custom maple bowl that was created by our local woodturner Marv N. So certainly Monday was a very busy day for ticket sales. Also, the foundation is currently developing a holiday campaign to encourage the public to donate to the NPCF and buy one of the unique comfort maple pens. The overall fundraising strategy for the foundation is also in its final stages of development, and the foundation plans to roll out that campaign in early 2023. So a lot of work's been done on that, and we're looking forward to that. And finally, the foundation is also working on a land securement giving program in consultation with Eric Baldwin, the NPCA manager of land planning. So lots to look forward to. So thank you.
Thank you, Member Cridlin. Any questions to Member Cridlin? Seeing none, now we will turn the meeting over to our CAO for her verbal updates.
Thank you, Chair. And I just wanted all the time that was left until noon to provide my update. I'll try to be brief so we can all go and call it a record meeting. Probably we'll finish soon. So good morning, everyone. A couple of updates just to add to Chair's update. I'll start with the funding announcement that was made earlier last week. So earlier this year, if you recall, in January, we had confirmation from Federal Economic Development Agency of Ontario, that's the federal government, on a $750,000 funding towards green infrastructure for our parks. We started the project earlier this year, and project is scheduled to be completed by March 2023. A lot of work has been done to upgrade our park assets at Cave Spring, Louth, St. John's, and planned for Rockway in the coming months. You can see some low-impact development features there at Cave Spring. We'll arrange for a site visit for board members to come and see what we have been able to accomplish with this money. That's $750,000. The announcement was made last week with the two MPs, Honorable Fulmona Tassi, Minister of FedDev, and myself, Chair, and Rebecca, and Director Christie. So this was a real proud moment. We've also received some other money recently through FedDev Ontario on the Holiday Trail initiative that happens in December, and we are planning that event. So that's part of the Tourism Relief Fund for that. So going on to the Thanksgiving Festival, our traditional 48th annual Boss Falls Festival. It was an incredible amount of people that showed up to the festival this year. Biggest ever. We welcomed 27,000 visitors over the course of 4 days. We were almost at this point of closing down the parking lot because it was just getting too much, and everybody was having a fun time. I offer my genuine appreciation for all the staff who work really hard to lead and deliver the event. It wasn't an easy one, and we offer a world-class event where people are coming from not just Niagara. You can talk to people, and they're coming from all over the GTA and other places, and some local tourists here as well. I also want to thank the board members and other volunteers who were able to come out and help us. And in 2 years, we are going to be celebrating the big 50th. So we've already started planning as to what that unique event might look like. And that big bang will start at the 49th next year. We might launch some new things and new announcements. So we're still working on what that might look like. Also, as I've mentioned earlier, we are improving our relation and collaborations with our First Nation partners. And in that spirit, a partnership with Niagara Fork Arts Festival was the first ever Indigenous-led event. I did provide an update to the board, but we had to cancel the Sunday at the last event in September. And we, sticking to our promise, we did book another Sunday past weekend, and we hosted that Sunday event with a lot of attendees. So that was a big success. Chair Foster mentions IJC. So it was a real great opportunity for NPCA to host the U.S. counterparts, American counterparts, and Canadian counterparts as part of the Great Lakes Forum International Joint Commission meeting. And this all showcases the work that is happening between Canada and Ontario and the United States on the Great Lakes Water Quality Agreement and other Great Lake initiatives. NPCA is an active partner in this. As you know, we are the delivery agent for the Remedial Action Plan. So we've been implementing stuff on site with federal and provincial funding. We hosted a Beyond the Falls tour, and this tour was a hot item for that event. Over 50 people attended the tour. It was booked overnight, and we heard some great comments and great testimonials on how effective our work has been, and we are getting close to delisting for beneficial uses on the RAP program. We highlighted our habitat restoration projects, our remediation efforts, Great Lakes fish monitoring, and community science initiatives along with Indigenous history. So moving on, as part of that whole event, there was a Great Lakes Forum hosted in Niagara Falls. I was there along with Natalie Green, Director Yates, and some other staff. We had a table there. It was some wonderful presentation, actually. I thank Mayor Easton, who was part of a panel, and she spoke highly about conservation authorities. So it gives me great pleasure to know that our partner municipalities and political leaders in Niagara are starting to see the value NPCA brings to the table when it comes to protecting our green space and waters in Great Lakes, and they are able to demonstrate that at these type of international forums. So thank you to her for doing that. Chair Foster and I, along with Natalie Green, who presented at the IJC meeting. So this was the IJC Water Quality Board that was meeting as part of that forum. Our staff presented there. Natalie presented. Chair Foster and I were able to answer several questions. In fact, our U.S. counterparts were really impressed to hear the work that conservation authorities are doing on the ground that is contributing to these international efforts. Sometimes people don't know the role we play and how effective we are in achieving these bigger international and national results. Finally, we had the Conservation Awards night. There was an excellent turnout on September 21st. We were able to recognize and celebrate NPCA volunteers and partners, over 150 attendees at that event, along with several board members. Chair Foster, previous Chair Johnson, were both part of the program. I know, Vice Chair, you attended. No, you're not there. Yeah, some other board members were there. Member Apley was there. Thank you to Member Apley for taking the time. Anyways, we had to give out awards for both 2020 and 2021. So my congratulations to all the recipients, award winners, residents, citizens who've been volunteering and supporting us. Please keep up the good work, and we are really thankful for your support. Thank you, Chair Foster.
Thank you very much. Member Woodhouse.
Oh, there you go. It's very encouraging every month that when we have our board meetings that all of these activities are underway on behalf of our authority. It's great to hear. My question is regarding Rockaway and our recent purchase of that property, which was fantastic. I drove by and I see that we put a sign up front of it, which is great, notifying the public that is now in our possession. At some point, will we be getting a progress report in terms of the advancement of that property and what's in store for it?
Yeah, we'll turn it over to Director Christie, but an excellent question. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you for the question, and through you, Chair. We can absolutely put together a report going, but the property is progressing. We're working with different landscape designs and concepts for the property, and currently planning a public consultation for all the residents and anyone that would like to join for mid-November, and hope to get the outcome out of that and start the project.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Member Rapley.
Yeah, thank you. I just want to compliment Chandra on the tremendous amount of activity and things that she has going on, and the staff. What they're getting done is amazing in this time when we have to struggle to really get things done. But I did it. I was for 5 years. I've been a citizen member of the Niagara Remedial Action, Niagara River Remedial Action Committee. And it was great to be able to attend this conference. I worked for over 20 years with IUCN in Ottawa and with our Great Lakes program at the Toronto Zoo. And it was great to get all the updates. I got to meet the Minister of the Environment and Climate in Canada. And it was super to get around and see what was going on. And I went as a citizen member of the committee, thanks to Natalie. And they are doing, Natalie and Heather Frank and people involved with that program are doing an amazing job. It's a committee that actually gets a lot done. And that's really unique sometimes these days. Also, I attended the Balls Falls on Monday, and I must say what a wonderful event it is for the community and for everything that's going on. So very positive feedback from me. I'm really pleased with what you are accomplishing. And I know we have obvious limitations, and I would like to say that perhaps with the restrictions and so on that seem to be coming in, the lack of planning, and whether our 3C option will remain in the region when it goes to the province and so on the table, that the acquisition of properties by NPCA may be more and more important as time goes on, and I really see that as very important. So thank you very much. Thank you, Chandra, for all your hard work.
Thank you, Member Rapley. Anyone else? Seeing none, we do not have a closed session. So to Member Hewson, good luck on Monday with your election campaign. We're all rooting for you. And you'll be back. And for everyone else, thank you very much for attending the meeting this morning. And with that, I am going to adjourn the meeting.